Frankly, be referred, because in research there is generally and some limitation. Generally, I mentioned one is geographical limitation, and another is time frame limitation. So the limitation, or if there is another other types of limitation in respect of document, in respect of locality, or anything else, it should clearly be referred. Adequate analysis, this is data should be adequately analysis, and findings should be clearly pinpointedly mentioned, and conclusion must to be justified. Now we are coming to the different segments of research which will help to develop idea about ethics and ethical problems in research. Literature review means the review of existing body of knowledge on a particular topic. Why it is being done? It is done because to avoid duplication of requirements. If the scholar doesn't know how far on the particular area research have been conducted, it will not be possible for him to start. If after doing research for some period, say 1 year, if he can identify that, oh, this has already been done somebody else, then his time. So to avoid duplication, literature review is must. Identify variables that influence my problem, because on the same topic or related topic or peripheral topics, research has been conducted by some other person. So if the researcher studied, reviewed literature and identified the variables, what procedures are adopted for conducting their research will ultimately help him to determine the variables, identify the variables. And similarly, identify the methodology, limit the problem, and to know the trend of research. If we go through the different sources like university journals and other things, that what research has already been done, then if we jot down all the research on a particular area, then we can easily identify the trend of research on that particular area, and ultimately helps in defining his area of study, identifying his research topic. Now, at the end of each scientific article, at the end of research, that each chapter, or at the end, in case of research, bibliography and references are given. Many a time we make confused between the two, but there is a huge difference between the two, bibliography and reference. Bibliography is the listing of all materials that have been consulted while writing an essay or writing an article. So it is all the documents the scholar, the author, the writer consulted for writing the paper or book. Develop his overall ideas on that particular topic. But reference are, on the other hand, those that have been referred in a particular book or article. So bibliography is not confined to the reference given in the document. It is the total broader canvas on which reference is drawn. Reference are directly cited in the text, bibliography is not cited in the text. So while giving references, we use some kind of referencing technique, use quotations within the text. But in case of bibliography, it is not required. Reference can be used to support the statement or argument. Bibliography doesn't have such kind of role. Both, but there are some similarities too, like both bibliography and references appears at the end of the document, but bibliography comes after reference. Bibliography may contain all that have been incorporated in reference, but reverse is not possible. I'm repeating. Bibliography may contain all that have been appeared in the reference, but reverse is not possible. Bibliographies are arranged alphabetically, but reference may be arranged alphabetically or numerically, depending upon the referencing style, citation style the scholar follow. Now, the citation. At the end of article, at the end of book, we cite different other documents. So citations are the references given at the end or within the text of scholarly papers and in their footnotes to the articles of documents previously published. So citations are the references given at the end of an article. A paper is cited in paper points out that it is an important and there is some relationship between the two. So the references, the citation in the form of reference given at the end, there is some relationship with the original text to support it, to oppose it, that is to analyze it, synthesis, or whatever may be. Then why citation is given? Actually, it is paying homage to the pioneers. So preceded, conducted research, and they lived it, reached up to certain point. We are doing from that point. So what they have done, what invented, what they have generated, with proper citation, we pay homage to them, giving credit to the related works, obviously identifying methodology, background reading, criticizing previous work. I told earlier that for through citation, we may take analysis, synthesis, antithesis. So criticizing also is also comes there to identify trend of research. For citation, there are different styles. Styles may vary from discipline to discipline, subject to subject. For example, for humanities, generally we follow MLA, Modern Language Association of America style. For social science, PhD and psychological association style. And marketing discipline, we follow Chicago Manual of Style. Again, for subject specific, for chemistry, ACS, the American Chemical Society style is there. For physics, generally AIP, American Institute of Physics style is there. Obviously, the publishing house would have its own style. Likewise, NISCIA, I mean National Institute of Science, Communication and Information Resources. Journal of all that scholar intends to follow. The basic facets remain the same. The basic facets are the author's name is in our name, the title of the book in top book, the year of publication, and pagination. They are common in all citation style in case of books. Similarly, in case of journal, obviously the author's name, the contributing title, the journal, the article, the journal's name, its volume, number, and year is also common to all styles. For example, in APA style, surname come first, comma, then first name and second name, abbreviated form of first name and second name, then year of publication comes within first packet. But in Chicago styles, the same thing, first name, surname, comma, then first name, second name, dot, year comes just simply, not with any bracket. So the facets remain same. If we go through different styles and compare, thus you can observe that the facets of information are the same. The representation or arrangement, permutation combination of the facets varies from style to style. Again, there are some reference management software too. In my video slides, I have given some reference of these softwares. These softwares are also capable to convert the presentation from one style to another, from APA to ALA or like that. Now, the most important concept, and it is the point of discussion nowadays, plagiarism. It is the use of words or ideas of another person as if they were his or her own words and ideas. So what is plagiarism? It is use of words or ideas of another person as if they were his or her own words or ideas. So it is nothing but use of another publication's production concept without crediting to the source, without recognizing the original contributor, without proper citation. So it is nothing but commit literary theft, present as new and original an idea or product from the existing. So when taken ideas from an existing and doesn't bother to give credit to him, the contributor, it is termed as literary theft. And how that looks like, how it looks like plagiarism. It is nothing but copying others' work, citing a source improperly, writing of references should follow strictly as per the style. So if anybody doesn't proffer site or engaged or introduce any false information in it, it comes out of the purview. Then the source is of source. Many times the person may even not know the original source. He just first of all, summarize, refer the original source. Many times we use secondary sources. That means we use quotation book and refer that without citing the original source of information. So as far as possible, one should go original source of information for citing references. Summarization should be shorter than the text. Many a time we summarize, we use some portion of a text from other sources, and it should be summarized form. That should be shorter from the other, and it should always be written in his or her own words. Own words is the thumb rule. Is text from others. Then second point about avoiding plagiarism is paraphrase. It is refer the original source. I mentioned earlier, original source have to be mentioned all the times. Produced text must be longer and shorter than original source, and it has to be written in scholars his or her own. In quotation, exact original reference has to be cited. The quotation must be exact from the source, without any addition or preposition or anything else. Obviously, at the beginning, middle, or end of the quotation, we can use the provision of giving three dots to avoid some portion of the of a lengthy text or lengthy quotation. No change, including punctuation, is allowed. No change is possible. If any word is changed, it may be given within parentheses, and its clarification should also be given. Date of access in case of web reference is important. Many a time we give web references, but forget to give date of access. Date of access is important because it is website information is not static, it is dynamic. The original host or web designer many a time inputs new data, new information. For example, in case of a university, today is vice chancellor is Professor X, but tomorrow the vice chancellor may be Professor Y. So if the scholars derive some information from the website from today, then vice chancellor is somebody. But if we mention the date, then it justifies that on that particular date he or she was the vice chancellor of that university. So while accessing or giving reference to a resource, date of accession must be assessed, must be given. Then what are the important checklists to avoid plagiarism? Double check in all citation for accuracy. Many a times we give citation and never check or recheck it. So it should be rechecked in case of pronunciation, in case of exact title, each of pages given in the citation and the journal names or books title. So it should be double checked. Make sure that text citation match with the sources listed at the end. Because in scholarly writing, if that is text is there, if you use quotation and at the end we give citation, so it and obviously after a good scientific article, the number of citation may be maybe 30, 40 or many more. So one citation may not be matched with the one text reference may not be matched with the citation given. So if for be sure, it should be checked, doubly checked, and proper establishment of with the text of reference help the examiner if you can easily locate the original source of material used in the check. So establishment of a link between the text and references must be there, and it should be in a systematic way following citation style or the guidelines or different citations manual, so that examiner or reviewer or reader would easily identify and check its authenticity. Now we are coming to the main or central concept of this presentation, that is ethics in research. Now, what is ethics? Ethics is norm or rule for conduct that distinguishes between acceptable and unacceptable behavior. So, in conducting social life in research, there are some behavior which are acceptable and which are unacceptable. So, ethics determines or distinguishes between the two behavior, acceptable and unacceptable. Ethics are discipline that studies standard of conduct, such as philosophy, theology, law, psychology, sociology. So it is a discipline of that study the standard of conduct. Obviously, different profession must have or have its own professional ethics. And in this respect, I would like to mention that there is some difference between profession and a vocation. A profession or a must have some professional ethics or code of conduct. A profession must have professional publication. A profession must have professional degrees. A profession must have professional association, to mention just a few. So likewise, medical is a profession, law is a profession, library, science, librarianship is a profession, because we fulfill all these criteria. So profession may have its own professional ethics. So what are the basics of ethical codes? Honesty. Honesty is the basics of ethics. Honesty in data, honesty in reporting, honesty in results, methods, procedures, application. So honesty is from beginning of the research up to the submission of the thesis, from conducting article to the publication of article, all the stages, data collection, reporting, results, honesty must be. Then informed consent. Many times we collect information from human source, from human population. In that case, a person whom we are gathering information who would be allowed knowingly, voluntarily, and intelligently, and a clear and manifest way gives. So data, information, from human population must have their consent, and the purpose must clearly be revealed to them that I am taking this information, I am gathering this data for the purpose, for purpose of this, and it is confident too. Objectivity, without any bias towards experimental design, data analysis, peer review, personal decision, and other aspects. In no way biased, the scholar would be biased in respect of any caste, creed, religion, biased in respect of any particular methodology, biased in respect of any particular methods of collection data. Which data, which methods will be followed must be based upon the objectivity of the research. Then integrity. If from this agreement, time we made promises to the population. Many a times we can promise to the higher authority which has granted certain grants which are given permission for conducting and research. Many a times we entered into agreement, but all cases, the promise, the agreement it must maintain consistently connection. And here, next point, basics of ethics, ethical codes are carefulness. It is important element to have an error and negligence in entire process of research. The process, the scholars must have to be careful enough for that he is conducting research and it has social, implications. Often a scientific knowledge should be shared. Look, we conduct research for scientific knowledge and it should be shared. Nowadays, the new concept have appeared that is termed as open source. As we are conducting research at the cost of money. So all the research output or benefit enter society. So research findings should be shared. Finally, respect for intellectual property, honor to parents, corporate, and other forms of intellectual property. There is a concept called copyright. Actually, it is a right the creator, author enjoys for his creation. According to Indian Copyright Act, the author during his lifetime enjoys the copyright of his creation, and after his departure, after his death, his legal hereditary enjoys the copyright up to 60 years. For example, Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore lived this earthly heaven in the year 1931. So, Vishwabharati enjoys the copyright up to 2001. After 2001, any publisher are able to produce Tagore's work because his copyright. So, while conducting research, copyright concept of copyright and copyright rules have to be followed. And basics of ethics code is confidentiality and anonymity. In respect of paper or grant submitted for publication, for example, for conducting a research or for conducting a for publication, some agencies give grants. So the granting authority's name must be labeled. And confidentiality on in all aspects of data collection to data publication must be maintained. And responsible publication. Publications should be responsible based on advanced research and other issues in respect of basics of research code are social responsibility. And important concept for geological research. There are some countries' basic fundamental general rules regarding care of animals. So while conducting research in geology, one have to follow the rules of that country regarding living animals. Similarly, discrimination in respect of anything, religion, methodology, biasness towards anything could be avoided. Ultimately, the social responsibility of research must adhere to because we have a social responsibility. Now, from this discussion, what are the core of ethics? This comes under the purview of ethics in research. What are the core of these things? Ethics is nothing but a branch of philosophy with moral problematics as it. So, approach of ethics in research is approach towards morality. Obviously, it depends upon culture. What is improper, unethical in Indian concept may not be as such or as much as improper or unethical in Western. So ethics is not a rigid thing globally. It may vary from culture to country. Dynamics changes time to time like other social behavior. So again, it may change from time to time. So it is dependent on culture, dependent on society, and dependent on time too. But the principle or core of ethics remain the same. What are those? Those are honesty, integrity, humility, kindness. That is the human qualities. Human qualities remain the same. So approach characteristics more moral than legal. Now, we discuss the ethics in research publication. Ethics in research publication has different components. First of all, we are discussing about ethics for authors. What ethical things authors should follow for publication. This paper should be based on strong thesis. So paper not just copying cut and paste things, copying something from here, something from there, and making and formatting it and submitting for publication is paper must from thesis. Data obtained ethically. Many data falsification is done. So what data object obtained must be proper data, and they must be obtained ethically. Data adequate in validity. Anytime old data, those are not proper validity. For example, if we use 2001 census data for writing an article in 2020, so those data has not the validity, because after 2001, 2011 census data is available. So it must be the latest, adequate in validity. Writing the paper must write his or her own words. Proper documentation must be given. Paper must be accurately written, made in clarity and understanding. Many a times, some other scholars wrote the paper, and with his personal relationship with somebody else, we asked to include his or her name, or he of his own includes his or her name. That is not proper or ethical. Similarly, documentation must be properly be given, accurately written, and so what is ethics for author? Again, the random publication. Avoid redundant publication. That means once a paper submitted for publication in a publishing house, the same paper should not be submitted to other houses or other journals for publication. If any journal house takes a long time, who is the contributor, who is the author, does not agree or does not ready to wait, he or she may has every right to withdraw his paper from that house and submit it to another house for publication. But without withdrawing submission of same paper with two and publication from the two houses is not. Perform literature search and cite the original part. While conducting literature search, original source of information must be mentioned, not taking the information from the secondary sources is permission. Actual scholarship depends on this, going to the original source, the originality, and quoting it, because the secondary source may misquote or may omit some portion of a valuable quotation, some words or lines of a valuable quotation which the present worker is conducting. So if he goes to the original source, it will be beneficial for him and authenticity will be maintained. Manuscript presented in a conference is permissible to submit for publication. Many times we raise a question, scholars raise a question, I have submitted this manuscript, I presented this paper in those conference, am I eligible to submit it for publication? Yes. Once a manuscript is submitted, presented in a conference and not published in conference volume or any other journal, any other volume, then he or she has every right to submit it for it or publication. Then authorship ethics. So much we discussed about ethics of author. Now we are coming to authorship ethics. Individual as author should have significant contribution. I gave a hint earlier, many a time a single paper contributors name 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Number of contributors has been increased mainly due to API score has become mandatory for career advancement of faculties. So many, that is the reality. But contributors, inclusion of contributors name or inclusion claiming of authorship must have significant contribution towards the article. Two concepts and design. The contribution may be in respect of concepts and design, analysis, interpretation of data, and both drafting or revising, etc. I mean, in any form, from design, analysis, collection of data, drafting, revising, or in case of interdisciplinary research, his contribution from other discipline must have some contribution to claim individual authorship. Participation solely in acquisition of funding or collection of data does not merit. Please remember, many a time that researcher sponsored research. So there are some funding agency. So funding agency couldn't claim authorship or collection of data from collection data from sources, from any sources, doesn't mean not claim authorship. If the data are collected from any web source or any other, citation will be given, but he or she can never claim authorship. Multiple authorship, order of author should be joint decision. Order of authorship should be a joint decision. Actually, in case of scientific publication, first author is principal author or corresponding author. It is generally, I have mentioned, it may vary from that. So, besides principal authors, remaining authors position, or among two, three contributors, who will be the principal authors, that should be the joint decision. And my, according to my observation, if the scholars and guides publish a paper jointly, scholars' name might come as principal. Authorship ethics. Co-author shares responsibility and accountability for the result. Co-author shares responsibility and accountability for the result. So if author's name is included in contributor's name, co-author's name, he or she has also the responsibility or have to be ready for any criticism of that paper, because he or she is responsible for the result also. Oh, my name came and third author. So I am not responsible, I have not seen it. So that is not the case. Once name included as co-author, he or she has the same responsibility like others regarding the results, regarding criticism and all that. Now the submission, before submission of article to any journals, my humble submission is that scholar should read few issues of that particular journal to assess himself, his quality, journal's quality, journal domain of publication, journal's credibility, and if possible, the impact factor of that particular journal. And in the guidelines of the journal, for the contributors, the guidelines, publishers' guidelines is given at the end of the journal or at the beginning of a new issues of a volume. At the end of a journal or at the beginning of a new issues of a volume. So the contributors should follow the guideline in respect of number of words, in respect of keywords, in respect of abstract, in respect of submission, in respect of review process, in respect of citation style followed by the journal. So all these things are given at the publisher's guideline. And the copyright. Now that whether the contributor, the scholar is submitting his copyright to the journal's editor, to the journals, or at the same time he and journal both restored their copyright, or it comes under open copyright licensing, everybody could get from it. So that should also under purview of the author. Manuscript has to be read and approved by each co-author. Many a time, one person out of many co-authors gone through the papers and is submitted. Oh, I included your name. No, that is not the case. Every contributor should read and approve the paper before submission. Citation discussed at length earlier. Then acknowledgement. Person with significant function and contribution to the work, but not justify authorship. So, after a scientific person, scientific article, acknowledgement may be given. For example, for conducting a research, a researcher may use the laboratory of a particular department or laboratory of a particular professor or library of particular library. In that case, the author may mention the author is indebted to professor such as such or department such as such for conducting the research. But that doesn't justify. So what are the ethical misconducts? what are the ethical misconducts? Ethical misconducts are fabrication. It is nothing but the behavior that makes up data or results and recording or report. So data manipulation, manipulation in result or manipulation in records is for smooth functioning, for smooth result, maintaining proper ethical conduct, accurate data must be recorded, accurate data must be analysis and report. Then falsification. Falsification is a behavior that manipulates research materials, equipment, process, or changing or omitting data or result. That is falsification. So research material, falsification in research materials, falsification in equipment, falsification in research process, are ethical misconduct. Plagiarism, I mentioned earlier, is a behavior that appropriates another person data, process, results, or words without giving credit. I have discussed on this aspect details earlier. Then, improprieties of authorship, like improper assignment of credit, that is also ethical. Then, violation of general acceptable research practice, respective practice in proposing, conducting, or reporting research. Obviously, there are some standard practice of research. So violation of that practice also comes under purview of ethical misconduct. Failure to comply with government requirement or contractual agreement. Obviously, governments when granting funds must have certain terms and conditions. Government in a country must have certain rules regarding care for animals, must have certain rules for human subjects, must have certain rules for drug control, its use and abuses. So while conducting research on these particular areas, taking funds from some sources, conducting research on animals or human being or drugs, so countries rule, country's basic fundamental rules on that areas must follow. But please remember, research misconduct does not include honest error or difference of opinion. Because in research, scientific papers, this is an answer. So difference of opinion is a common thing in academic arena. So that is not misconduct. Or in case of honest error, or numerical mistakes, numerical omit doesn't come under the ethical purview of ethical misconduct. So these are the ethical part on behalf of the research publication. But researchers publication. But researcher submits his research output in the form of research article to publisher or publication to the editor of a journal. So the publication, the publisher, the editor must have also some ethics to follow. He has also some responsibility towards the scholars. He has also some responsibility towards academic community. He has also some responsibility towards academic integrity. So what are those ethics have been discussed under the following slides. Ethics for public. Actually, academic publishing depends on trust. Trust. In everywhere in academic publishing, trust is editors trust the reviewers for proper assessment. Because after getting a paper, the editor sent it to the authors for blind peer review. That means without mentioning the contributor's name and his affiliation, the paper is sent to the reviewer for review. So editor trusts the reviewer that he will properly assess the paper and give his consent, give his opinion about its acceptance, rejection, or modification. So editor trusts the reviewer, authors trust the editor for selection of appropriate reviewer. Similarly, author also trusts that editor will do justice to his paper. He will send to proper reviewer for proper evaluation, and ultimately the reader trusts the editing process and that journal as a whole. So ethics of publication. So ethical part on behalf of the publishers So solely based on trust in each child, from contributor to editor to reviewer, from user or reader or general scholar to its editor and journal as a whole. Now, transparency. Funding, disclosure, researcher, originality. So while publishing, publisher should be transparent that if the publisher is funded by some other agencies, government or any other NGO or any other organization, national or international, so fund that should be disclosed. Researcher should be honest, should be transparent in submitting his output, research output, and it should be original. Promoting research integrity, research misconduct, respect to culture and heritage. So research integrity must be adhered to and it is relating to research misconduct, respect to country's culture and heritage. Every country has its own culture, every country has its own heritage. So it shouldn't do anything, any scholar shouldn't do anything, should write anything which hampers the country's basic social ethos. Editorial standard and process, that is a peer review system. In peer review system, under the editorial board, there are some research person. They are expert on that particular area of research on particular domain. After getting the paper, the editorial board, chief editor, or the editorial assistant send it to proper person for review. The reviewer reviews it. Following certain review guidelines, he or she may accept, reject, or ask for modification, and the contributor have to comply those things. And at any stage, the confidentiality from the editorial part must be maintained. Responsible publishing practice, author, reviewer, press, and press, in every way, responsible publishing practice should be followed. That is following the proper pipeline, sequence of submission on the part of publisher, on the part of a reviewer. It shouldn't be retained for a long time. One paper submitted for review and the reviewer is keeping in his drawer for a longer period. That shouldn't be. And ownership of ideas and expression, that is the plagiarism and copyright that I have narrated earlier. That also comes under the purview of ethics of publication. A committee on publication ethics, comprising of more than 9,000 editors. Editors are member of COPE. COPE means Committee on Publication Ethics. Started its journey in 1997 in UK. The committee established to discuss, advise, and resolve ethical aspect of publishing. So, if any point of time there is serious conflict, there is serious ethical question arise in the publishing house, arise in between the peer and publisher or author or publisher, then that is not being settled amicably, then the Committee on Publication Ethics, comprising of editors of different reputed journals, take decisions. Now I am coming to the conclusion part of my presentation. Actually, it is an approach. An entire ethical concept is approach towards morality. So depends upon the human values, human morality, whether ethical ideas, ethical concept will be adhered or not. Depends upon the ethical standard of individual institutional countries as a whole. So ethics, application of ethics, not only depends upon individual's ethical standard, but also the institutional ethics and the country as a whole. Depends on academic environment and research culture of a nation. If the academic environment is good, really truly academic, as free, freedom of speech and freedom of expression is there, and research culture is there, research funding is there for young generation, then ethical standard will be high, and socio-economic, socio-culture, and socio-political aspect of the country also influence research ethics or ethical part of research. If the socio-economic condition is good, if the socio-cultural aspect is high, if socio-political situation is stable, then obviously research and research will be boosted and ethical standard in research will develop. An ultimate object of is to create a knowledge society. Main purpose of research is to create a knowledge society, create an academic atmosphere, create an environment to quote Tagore, where the mind is without fear and head is held high. Chitto jeta bhoy shunno uccho jeta shakti. So to create such an environment is ultimate object of research and research ethics. Thank you. Thank you all for your presence.
Thank you, Parthada, for your nice and informative deliberation. I think our participants have benefited with your nice presentation and your informative sharing. So now we are going to open the house for the discussion. So may I request all of the participants keep their audio off, and those who want to ask the questions, you may ask one by one. So everyone will listen and everyone will be benefited with the questions and the answers. So I unmute all and please maintain the cues. Now you may raise your question. Any questions from the participants? Any questions?
Any question, please?
So if there is no question, so we can end the session. If you have any question, you may raise your question. You can send your question to the chat box. Vasudha, you may follow the chat box and find any questions you may answer from there also. पावर चला गया, अनकनेक्टेड। आउट ही कर दे।
आउट नहीं है तो, एक मोन नेटवर्क।
कैसे सेव हो गया?
बंद करने की जरूरत नहीं। जाएगा नहीं बोल। ठीक नहीं करना। ठीक है, देखा।
आरती भी नहीं चला है। पातो दा।
वही कैसे पातो दा?
एमी नेटवर्क का किले कैसे? एक मिनट ये तो है, पहले नेटवर्क तो है।